I would say Africana Studies found me as opposed to the other way around. Little did I know at that time that experience would fundamentally alter my life. I think it was 1986. There was a special program here at Cornell, and I got a chance to meet James Baldwin and so many figures, Gwendolyn Brooks, Haki Madhubuti. You know, these are folks I'd read about. And so those interactions for us created a sense of obligation to further the kind of work that these leading thinkers, scholars, cultural workers were engaging in. All of the liberal arts disciplines have been impacted by Africana Studies. You can't take a course in history today and not see the influence of Africana Studies. Same thing for English, same thing for sociology, etc. And so there are a number of theories, methods that we have used and introduced that have fundamentally changed traditional disciplines. So building upon that legacy going forward is something that Africana Studies will continue to do in spite of those who are not keen of what we represent as a discipline. But that's the nature of our struggle, and we welcome and embrace that as we go forward.